Jai Gurudev. I want to share my experiences, which started as a student of chemistry in Benares Hindu University, and later I did my post-graduation in chemistry, especially physical chemistry, and then I did my physical chemistry specialization as electrochemistry PhD, and then I became a reader and professor in chemistry in Andhra Pradesh because Param Pooja Gurudev. And when I say Param Pooja Gurudev, I always mean Yugadrashta, Taponishta, Vedamurti, Param Pooja Gurudev, in whom and with whom. I'm using the words very carefully, in whom and with whom. In whom is inner awakening of his. And with him, I could get the flame, the light of inner awakening. So in whom and with whom I learned this knowledge in 1971, 18th June evening, 4:30. I'm continuing. As a lecturer, I used to tell my students in post-graduation when I was teaching them, the physical biochemistry, I'm not talking the biochemistry of it, the physical biochemistry. So what fundamentally we have to be very clear is, we should forget the word spiritualism. We should forget the word materialism. Because these two words nowadays are almost 180 degrees away from each other. Materialists think the spiritualists are fanatics, and spiritualists say that materialists are fanatics. And when I say fanatics, it means they are steady on their thinking. I'm not talking the negative way, I'm talking in their stubbornness. So, the fundamental thing which we have to know is, there is a union, a yoga, a relationship between materialism and spiritualism. And that relationship is nothing new to us. It is our life. The material body is active with some consciousness which thinks. Some consciousness where thoughts become emotions. So, entire spiritualism is the science of living, the laws of living. That is how we should now look towards spiritualism. And now we are away from life, we don't know how to live. What we are doing as a service, whether it is a political field of service, or a business field of service, or a scientific field of service, or an actor, or a fine art field of service, or a teaching field of service. You please remember these five. These are five fields of services which we do. Either it is a political service, through politics, or through business, or through science, or through fine arts and acting. What we call the Bollywood and Hollywood centers, and then the teachers. But these five are now away from life. This is what we have to understand, and this is the first thing, the greatest thing that Param Pooja Gurudev has given is the relationship of these five with five elements. All of us, those who are interested in this field, know that we are made up of five elements. The life is made up of five elements. What in Sanskrit we say, it is made up of five tattvas. The prithvi, the earth principle. And remember, I am not saying the earth, I am not saying about the matter. I am saying the principle of earth. You should understand the difference. Out of earth principle, everything solid and material comes in the world. It is the basis, like electricity is the principle, and all these machines are the product of electricity. Whether it is a mic, or a fan, or a fridge, or a computer, and probably whatever is going to come as a recent discovery or later discoveries. So all these are based on the electric principle. And the products, the matter, is the product of electric principle. Therefore, when you want to understand life, you should understand that the element earth is electricity itself. That is the jump we have to take, the science we have to understand. Because matter is made up of atoms, and atom is nothing but a positive and negative electron. A nucleus with positive energy and electrons running around it. All of our body is made up of positive and negative atoms, molecules, and we say about the hormones, the neuron transmitters, or whatever you call it. Now, when I say the earth principle, I'm talking about electricity. And because many yogis, when they talk about the Prithvi principle, and we think about the physical body and not the electrical nature of it, the confusion comes. That is where much of the science in the yogic literature has been lost. Because the principles have not yet been understood, and Param Pooja Gurudev and his wife, Mata Bhagavati Devi Sharma, and in the middle you see a figure, Gayatri. And this Gayatri is a figure of life. The life depends on two things, sunlight and water. Every scientist accepts it. Wherever you want to search about life, that is what exactly the scientists search. Is there water? Is there light? And then they say, yes, there is a possibility that there is life. So that is the two hands, what that figure has. One is a kamandalu where water is there. Anybody can show it, please, what I am talking about. And you should please excuse me, because of some physical discomfort I am sitting. Don't think. So kamandalu, that is what the yogis have as a water container. And then the next one is light. Light means knowledge, the light of knowledge. So these two are the basis of life. And what life is, in Sanskrit it is called Gaya, Gayan. A Sanskrit word for life is Gayan. Trayati means that which gives support. So that which gives support is Gayatri. And many of us, we have forgotten about this thing, that it supports life. We think she is goddess somewhere in the skies. And remember, electricity is not somewhere in the skies. The electricity is inside you. Every atom is full of your in. That is the inner awakening about which I am going to tell. And it is a very, very, very simple process, because you already have it. You have to discover it. And to discover, what you have to do? Nothing. You have to just remove the lid. We again search, that is what research is. The words in science we use, discovery and research. Don't you think that these words carry an inherent meaning, that you already have it? Don't you think so? You think about the words? But we have forgotten so much to think about the words, that we think we have to discover he has invented something which is new to the world. Discovery means it is already there. Newton discovered gravity, or the laws of gravity. So do you think he has created them? No. He has discovered them. He awakened to it. Similarly, you can get an inner awakening by a very, very, very simple process. The entire development of science is based on going to the fundamentals. As a chemistry lecturer, I know that the real science developed when people discovered atom as we understand now, not atom as Dalton discovered. Should I go in this direction? All of you are following what I am talking about? When I talk about the Dalton's atom, the atom itself means it is indivisible. That is how it started. The going towards the fundamentals of atom, matter, he went to the atom and he said it is indivisible. Then after a few centuries, we get Niels Bohr, Rutherford, and other scientists, and they said atom is divisible. But again they call it atom. They have not changed it. You remember that? I'm trying to tell you about Gayatri. That is what I'm trying to explain. You can't change the word Gayatri. You have to know the meaning of it. Why? Just as the original Dalton's atom is indivisible. They learned for 200 years or so. After that, suddenly they knew that atom is divisible into three particles. The electrons, the neutrons and protons, and the nucleus, of course, containing protons and neutrons. All of you are able to hear, na? Clear? Okay. Because I am moving away from the mic, so I am just confirming myself. Okay. After that, suddenly, Max Planck and others found something inconceivable. That actually electron has a dual nature. It is a wave of electron and it is a negative particle. A wave of electron is energy and an electron is a particle. And now what you say? It is divisible? It is indivisible or it is energy? The dual nature, the matter and energy are convertible. And that led to, of course, the nuclear energy and the atom bomb. Let us not talk about it. But what I am trying to tell, with all that, still we are using the word atom. But our concept, our understanding has changed. Similarly, if in this today's interaction, if I could convince that that Gayatri about which Parampuja Gurudev is talking about has nothing to do with a Hindu goddess, it has nothing to do with Hindu religion. It has nothing to do with any religion. When you say Newton's laws, do you think he has the commander and it is Newton's, what we call when you want to say that this is mine? Some copyright or what we call? Patent. You can't say that Newton says that I have patent over gravitational law because I have discovered it. And suppose he applies. I don't know whether you give it or not, but you should not be given, because how can it be a patent which is natural? Am I able to make you convey my feeling? I don't think about the criticism aspect of what I am telling. I want you to understand that how to live is what Gayatri Mantra is. And how to live, it doesn't involve only human beings. Animals are involved. Plants are involved. And if you go deeper, the mineral atoms are also involved. Hydrogen atoms live like a hydrogen atom. Chlorine atom lives like a chlorine atom. And they don't change. And the conservation of mass and energy has a very beautiful offering to us to understand. Neither matter can be created or destroyed, neither energy can be created or destroyed. What can you do? You can just interchange. So number of hydrogen atoms is fixed. Number of uranium atoms, I don't know if they convert into lead atom about the radioactivity aspect, but it is also fixed. But the way they live, the mineral kingdom, how it lives. The plant kingdom, how it lives. The animal kingdom, how it lives. This is the basis of the three levels of Gayatri. Gayatri means, always remember we are talking about the laws of life. I am not talking about any goddess. And laws of life is common to minerals, plants, and animal kingdom. That is what Parampuja Gurudev has given to the world. That now let us stop about thinking about all these religions and all these concepts. Let us start living. Let us understand living. Let us live. And then you have to name it. Just as I said, we don't change the name of atom, but our concepts have changed. Similarly, the Hindu concept, the Christian concept, the Muslim concept about life is almost similar. How to live? Do you think people live in a different way? So that is what we are trying to give to the world, to humanity, that let us learn how to live. Let us know the laws of nature. And the laws of nature are nothing but the laws of life. So with this basic concept, let us always remember that whenever we talk of about any religion, it talks about how to live. It gives you a methodology, a system based on natural laws. Always on natural laws, any religion. And what is the natural law? Any science has developed only when we go to the fundamentals. The more fundamental things you discover, greater is the science building that is built. An indivisible atom is a small chemistry. A divisible atom is a bigger chemistry. Energy and matter are interconversible atom, today's chemistry, and we don't know what happens tomorrow. So, when we talk about living, about life, what is fundamental to us? What is fundamental to all of us? Breathing. Breathing is the most fundamental thing in the world. And breathing gives life. You always remember that even in coma, if the breath is going on, we say he's living. And there are many centers I heard, I don't know, so you just don't catch my collar and say where they are. I just heard that those who are in coma since 20 years or so, they're still being said they are alive, and people are trying to find some medicine or some methodology, and if we can discover how to bring them out of coma, they are alive. Why I'm giving this example is, breathing is the most fundamental of life. So that is what Gayatri means. Gayan Trayati Iti Gayatri. That which protects life is Gayatri. Why I'm trying to give this nomenclature is, the basic nomenclature when you don't understand, we can't build the edifice of inner awakening. So breathing, it is the breathing which gives us inner awakening. But we are only aware of breathing when we have some cold or some asthmatic problem. Then we think, yes, I am not able to breathe properly. If not, you just don't care and you just don't realize how you breathe. And now, the modern cardiologists, a series of cardiologists, you can see the website, they talk about relaxation response. And they are all cardiologists, high-level cardiologists from different countries. You just type relaxation response in the website, Google search, and it opens. Now, that is what we need. Now we have a stress response and a strain response towards life. That is the problem. The most incurable diseases which we have, which can be maintained at a bearable level, the diabetes, the heart and BP, and the cancer. These cardiologists say that if we can develop the relaxation response, 80% of these diseases are cured. 80% of these problematic diseases for us, once if you are diabetic or if we are what we call the BP or heart problem or with cancer, we know that we have to take medicine continuously. But these doctors, they say if you can know the relaxation response, 80% of these so-called incurable diseases are cured. And I have myself seen a few people. But why I'm telling about the doctors is, that is more authentic. I have seen it, okay, you must have seen, I don't see. You go to the web and see. But this relaxation response to life should dominate or displace the stress relationship response and the strain response. That is the process of Gayatri. That is what Gayatri is. There is nothing there with divinity or this law and this. If you have these problems, if you have the relaxation response, you are cured. For that relaxation response, the basic methodology that these cardiologists give is, observe your breath. Be aware of your breath. Many times we are not aware of your breath. That is just what I started in the beginning. Because we are in the inner awakening, I said, be aware. Be aware of where your hand is, where your leg is. Be aware of your entire body. And slowly when you start being aware of it, suddenly you awaken to the sounds of heart, to the sounds of the what I call the four lobes of the brain, the frontal, the back and the side lobes, the four lobes of the brain. You will understand what is happening between them. And the yogis, about talking about the Gayatri mantra, gives you the methodology in which you can understand how the inner energy relaxes. And diabetes is because the inner energy is not in a relaxed condition. You know that diabetes is because of the sugar. And you know that sugar is the cause for our energy. That much all of you know. Whatever you eat, it becomes a sugar and gives energy. So why we get diabetes? Because the energy is not correct. It is under stress and strain. And if you relax it, now, that is what we need. Now we have a stress response and a strain response towards life. That is the problem. The most incurable diseases which we have, which can be maintained at a bearable level, the diabetes, the heart and BP, and the cancer. These cardiologists say that if you can develop the relaxation response, 80% of these diseases are cured. 80% of these problematic diseases for us, once if you are diabetic or if we are what we call the BPR heart problem or with cancer, we know that we have to take medicine continuously. But these doctors, they say if you can know the relaxation response, 80% of these in so-called incurable diseases are cured. And I have myself seen a few people. But why I am telling about the doctor says, that is more authentic. I have seen it. Okay, you must have seen. I don't see. You go to the web and see. But this relaxation response to life should dominate or displace the stress relationship response and the strain response. That is the process of Gayatri. That is what Gayatri is. There is nothing there with divinity or this law and this. If you have these problems, if you have the relaxation response, you are cured. For that relaxation response, the basic methodology that these cardiologists give is observe your breath. Be aware of your breath. Many times we are not aware of your breath. That is just what I started in the beginning. Because we are in the inner awakening, I said, be aware. Be aware of where your hand is, where your leg is. Be aware of your entire body. And slowly when you start being aware of it, suddenly you awaken to the sounds of heart, to the sounds of the what I call the four lobes of the brain, the frontal, the back and the side lobes, the four lobes of the brain. You will understand what is happening between them. And the yogis, about talking about the Gayatri mantra, gives you the methodology in which you can understand how the inner energy relaxes. And diabetes is because the inner energy is not in a relaxed condition. You know that diabetes is because of the sugar. And you know that sugar is the cause for our energy. That much all of you know. Whatever you eat, it becomes a sugar and gives energy. So why we get diabetes? Because the energy is not correct. It is under stress and strain. And if you relax it, diabetes is cured. And then the circulation of the blood. It is under stress and strain. You get BP. And then, of course, the heart attacks and this and that. But if the circulation is proper, and then cancer, cells. Kidney has a cell. The kidney system has their own cells. The heart has got its own cells. The digestive system has got its own cells. They all work correctly, no problem. But some cell somehow says, I want to be independent. I will do what I want. That is cancer. I want to do what I want. I don't follow nature. But you have to follow nature. If you don't follow nature, no science is there. All sciences are following nature. And because we have forgotten our nature, and what is our nature? The way we breathe. Our breath is our nature, our basis, our fundamental. So the first step of understanding the inner awakening is, first realize that you are your breath, not the body. Because of the breath, the body is there. If the breath is not there, who cares about the body? Even our very close members, suddenly the breath stops and people will try to see how. Is it not? So, really you are the breath. First you remember this. And next what? This breath is converted into three states. The cellular state is known as the awakened consciousness, the physical consciousness. We are aware of the physical life. The conscious life. The physically conscious life, the material life, where we interact with so many people. And the circulatory life, the dream state. And unfortunately, many of us don't know that many of the scientific discoveries are based on dreams. You just refer. As a chemistry lecturer, I know that almost 90% of the chemistry discoveries were because of dreams. But when you have physically exerted, when you have experimented, and then your dream gives you an idea. So the circulation process. And what is the circulation process? The blood circulation process. And if you have the correct way of circulation, you will not have any heart problem or blood problem. If you know the correct way of physical life, conscious life, no cancer. You try to understand these fundamentals. And the logic you are able, I think you can easily grasp it. But of course, to understanding the logic that atom is the basis, and to know the atom and to learn it, it needs a study. You have to, just a lecture will not help you. But this motivates you. So the physical consciousness, stress and strain is cancer. If the relaxation response is there, cancer is cured. If the circulation, the fluid which activates the brain, it is the blood circulation which activates the brain. So our thinking process, many people think it is in the brain. It is not in the brain, it is in the heart. If the blood circulation is a bit lowered, your brain goes. And your thinking process goes. Circulation. The thinking process, the stress and strain of thinking process, the brain process, cures heart problems. And then the energy problems, I told you, the sugar problem, the energy problem is diabetes. You are able to understand where I am driving you. I am driving you from a stress and strain response to these three states. And these three states of consciousness, we generally name it as the physical conscious, the dream consciousness, and the sleep consciousness. The physical, the dream, and the sleep. And these three ways of life in which we live, these three states of consciousness in which we live, is the three steps of Gayatri Mantra. Tat Savituru Varenyam. Bhargo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yonaha prachodayat. And now many people ask me, you are talking in Sanskrit. No, I am not talking any Sanskrit. I am talking science. How? When I was taking chemistry classes for degree graduates in our college. One day I entered the class. Just before my class, it was a class of some English lecturer, and something was written there, and the students have just wiped off, but only two letters were there, N and O. No. N letter and O letter. I saw it. But I am a chemistry lecturer. For me it is not no. I know what it is. I don't know how the relation between these similar pronunciations, K N O W no and N O no. But the alphabetical N O no means no, negative. But for chemist, it is nitrogen and oxygen. It is nitrous oxide, a laughing gas. It makes you laugh. Similarly, when I'm uttering these letters of Gayatri Mantra, there is no Sanskrit in it. There is no English in nitrous oxide. You accept that point? I am able to convey to you. You are utilizing the English alphabet, but what it conveys to you is not the English alphabetical meaning. It conveys a scientific meaning. The same thing is happening in Gayatri Mantra also. You want this NO no and it becomes negative. But if you know what NO means, that is KNOW no, something happens. A deep knowledge dawns on you. So this scientific aspect of Sanskrit literature, when not understood, all the Vedas are misunderstood. If those who know about the English pronunciation and English alphabets and they don't know the signs, Vedas can't be known. That is what happened. And the mother of all Vedas is Veda Mata, the mother of all Vedas is Gayatri Mantra. So when I say you do that, when I say that you just, if you want to know the radioactivity and the energy aspects, and you should know that E is equal to mc squared, mass energy equivalence formula, am I asking you to learn English? Do you think I am asking and forcing you to learn English? And you say, no, I don't want it, they are English letters. What happens? You will never learn the mass energy equivalence. So that is the mistake, what happened to the Vedas. The science has become something which has been thrown aside and now nobody understands it. But if the mother is alive, what is the mother? The life. And what is the life? Three levels of consciousness. The physical conscious, wakeful consciousness, the dream consciousness, the sleep consciousness. And what are the rules that control is? Tat Savitur Varenyam. The physical consciousness is controlled by sun. Can anyone deny it? Your physical life has a direct relationship to sun. And not only your life, any life pattern on planet Earth or anywhere, it is based on sun. Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi, removal of that knowledge. When you can dream what you can't think of. All discoveries are first dreams. Flying in air was a dream. Landing on the moon was a dream. The satellites were a dream. Don't you think so? What I am talking about, I am conveying you. If the dreams can be brought down, it becomes a discovery. Again, try to understand, if a dream is brought down, it becomes a discovery. What does it mean? If you know how to dream, you can change your life. If a scientific dream becomes a discovery, why can't your dream become a discovery in your life? That is the inner awakening which Gayatri Mantra gives. How to do? I am not explaining the formula, I am giving you the fundamentals. And if you are interested about it, there are two websites. But don't forget, I am talking about the basics of life. First is breathing, and I was talking about relaxation response. And before relaxation response, I talked about the stress and strain response which creates these problematic diseases. And if you know the relaxation response, very easily you can come out of it. And the basis of this is Gayatri Mantra, the formula how to do it. And what to do it? We have to control our wakeful life, the dream life, and the sleep life. The inner awakening is more in the dream and sleep state rather than in the physical plane activity. That is what the yogis give. And once I was reading a book, I just don't remember the author, it is De Bono or Stephen R. Covey, one who teaches about the multinational companies, how to think, they give lectures. Have you heard about these names?
De Bono, lateral thinking.
De Bono and?
Lateral thinking.
Half. And then Stephen R. Covey. Why I'm telling it? When they are talking about how to think, and it is based on psychology, and many of the psychological units, the psychological professors and this and that, I know many of my friends are psychological professors who talk about the science of thinking and this and that. They always tell me, Dr. R.K., one thing is, we feel very bad that much of our knowledge about brain has come from diseases. What we have learnt about brain is not because we have analyzed a healthy brain. Some collapsed brain or this, and we get the knowledge. If we can study a healthy brain, that healthy brain is from a saint, from a Christ. It's Jesus who has become a Christ. A Muhammad who has become a prophet. They are healthy brains. The yogis are healthy brains. Nostradamus has a healthy brain. Jean Dixon has a healthy brain. And 1945, Edgar Cayce has a healthy brain, where you see prophecies and thinking about the future. And many people think they are specially born with those talents. We don't know our future. Are we not lying to ourselves? You say that on such and such a date, I'm going to marry my daughter at that particular place, I'm inviting you. What are you talking about if not a prophecy? Is it not a prophecy? You are sure that you are going to do it, is it not? Very rarely it misses. And you say, I'm not a prophet, what do you mean? Maybe we are not of that level of prophet where Jean Dixon and Edgar Cayce or the yogis are. But we know about future. We talk about future. I'm going to build a house. I'm going there. I told you I'm coming to America on such and such a date, 3 months back. Is it not a prophecy? But because all of us have this prophecy, we say it is common prophecy. And when someone talks about the coming prophecy like Param Puja Gurudev, when he says that even though many scientists and many economists and many medical people say that the pollution, the population increase, the increase in carbon dioxide, the rent in the ozone layer is a very dangerous symptom. Anytime anything may happen, but he says, why I say he says, throughout in the literature, I'm very much interested in reading so many books, always people talk about the probability of some fantastic danger. And many people almost go to the edge of saying that the entire planet Earth will go. There is a website, 2112, right? You see the website, he predicts it, that out of 100 human people, 90 will die by that date, 2012. They hear some logic, but he is the man who says it is protected. Now you understand, and then you say, how could you do it? You can dream of it. If you dream it and you can make it physical, it becomes a fact. You understood this? That is the inner awakening. It is not just sitting, closing, and you feel that something is awakened, and you get up and you start a normal life. No. You have to awaken to your dreams. And he says, I have dreamt. I know, K-N-O-W know, not this know. The world is saved, but let us cooperate. Let us understand. In this period of crisis, where the politicians, the business people, the scientists, the actors, and fine art people, and the teachers are not even giving any thought to this problem, let us think. The thought becomes a dream, and the dream becomes a fact. That is the science of Gayatri. And this science, you can get it in Akhila Vishwa Gayatri Parivar, awgp.com. .org. A series of lectures by him in Hindi, of course, and he's in, and you have the AWGP English version, some given by me and given by others in AWGP South. And then there is a university which started by him. There are 5 courses. A university, what in our present language say, recognized by the government. And 2 German universities and 1 China university is linked with it. So there are 5 courses which are important. The first one is development of health. Development health, swasthya nirman in Hindi it called, health management. We are not healthy. Don't you feel? Comparatively, the general health condition is okay. But are we healthy? Do you feel that you are not tired? So that science is taught in 6 months course in that university. It is known as the Deva Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya. And you can go to the web. You have the English versions of all these things. That's the first is health management. But having a good health, and if your personality is not molded, if your thinking process has not been molded, if your way of living has not been molded, so personality mold, vyaktitva parishkar, personality molding, okay, health and personality is molded. Don't forget, in few minutes I will stop the lecture, but don't forget I am talking about the fundamentals of life, breathing, and next, what I was telling? Relaxation response. That is the fundamentals. And I am driving all these things, and these you can easily get if these 2 you are aware of. You are aware of your breath, and you can respond in a relaxed way to the problems which now are giving you stress and strain. That is Gayatri. So I was talking about health management, and then I am talking about the university. Deva Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya at Haridwar, he has started it. Then I talked about personality refinement. And then we should have a family. Many people think we are talking about the physical family. No, when we talk about the family, the chemistry is a family of scientific research. Physics is a family. You understand what I mean by family? The way in which you go and think and work. So that is family management. But with all that, the culture has to be managed. Deva Sanskriti. Our culture is very, very physically oriented. We don't know how to culture our dreams. We don't know how to culture our sleep. We have to learn it. That is the divine culture. Don't think that something divine is somewhere high. It is in you. And if the divine is not in you and the divine is outside, he is of no use. You remember it. Any knowledge which is outside you is of no use. If you are an engineer, if you are an engineer, that engineering is inside you. If it is in the college or in the university with the professor, what is the use of it? If you read medicine, and if that medicine is not inside you, and you say, okay, I will just ask my professor what medicine I am supposed to give, will you go to the doctor? So it should be inside you, the culture. That is how we should cultivate ourselves. And when we talk about a culture, a Hindu culture, other cultures, it means the majority of the Hindus and others behave like that. They are cultivated to think like that. So that is the fourth step, cultivation, Deva Sanskriti. And the last and the most important thing is a technique of union of all these states of consciousness, Yoga Sanskriti. What is the union? The union of the physical life with the dream life, the union of the dream life with the sleep life. And when all these three are linked, your sleep, your dream, and your awakening, you reach a combined state of consciousness. That is what is known as the transcendental state of these three. And in a real science of Gayatri, we call it as Samadhi. Sama means equal and Dhi means knowledge. Equal knowledge of all these three states. And if you have these three states, if your goal is to enter into these three states, what is the fundamental difference in these three states? Your evaluation of time. Is it not? In the physical plane, all of us have the same 24 hours, whether you like it or not. But in dream state, your time sense varies. Is it not? And in sleep state, you forget about the time. Or you go beyond time. Because if you are really asleep, you just don't know that you are asleep. You will only know it after you get up. And how much time you have slept without seeing a watch, you can't tell. So these three states of consciousness are based on time. The physical consciousness is based on 24 hours. And that is why the physical plane life is based on 24 letters in Gayatri Mantra. So each letter is related with 1 hour of our daily life. And those letters, you don't think it is Sanskrit. They are embedded in our bodies. They are ingrained in our bodies. They are written in our bodies. You can see them. There is a book, Human Physiology by Tony Nader. You know about Maharshi Mahesh Yogi? You must have heard. How many of you heard about Maharshi Yogi? His book has proved it. It is already in your body ingrained, you have to see it. And he is a neurologist. He is not a yogi. He is a neurologist. Now, of course, he has become a yogi. And if you know the history of his, he has become Nader Ram or Ram. So I'm not talking about it. But if you want to understand this, go to the Maharshi Yogi web. You will be given a proof that all these divine incarnations are in our body. The letters are in our body. What we call the nerve plexus in English, in physiology, the yoga says it as the shat chakras. Is it core or heart? No, this is not meant for you. The shat chakras. They are written in the body, these letters of Gayatri Mantra. You can see it. And if you want these photos and this, you can go to the akhilavishwagayatriparval.org, the Mahesh Yogi, what we call, the name of the Mahesh Yogi website? You just type Mahesh Yogi and you get it.
Maharshi Mahesh Yogi
website. Or Akhilavishwa Gayatri Parivar South website. Or you can go to any website with your question, you get the needed opening. So this is the real inner awakening, that you are awakened to the physical consciousness of 24 hours, the dream consciousness where you are the controller of the time. Within few seconds or few minutes, you experience thousands of years of experience sometimes. But certainly you can be sure that your time speed is much more in dreams, and you experience everything very clearly. Is it not in dreams? The experience is as clear as your day-to-day life. And in sleep state, what happens? You go beyond time. And now, the yogic culture, what Parampuja Gurudev gives you a hint to bring heaven on earth is, if you can reach the sleep state where there is no time, naturally the time has become so fast that you are not able to record. And if you get an experience of few hundreds of years in few seconds or minutes in dream state, your experience of heaven on earth, can't you get it instantaneously in sleep state? That is a question what yogis prove that it is possible. And that samadhi state is not simply to the yogis. There are so many saints in other places in the world where they prove that their blessing is enough to regenerate you. The incurable disease cures. That is the samadhi state. The process is again given in Gayatri Mantra. And again, the most important thing what I am trying to tell you is to awaken it, be aware of your breath. That is what I first tell you every time. I am closing the lecture, awakening, inner awakening. Be aware of your breath. Wherever you are aware of the breath, you are aware of yourself. Because you are the breath. Because the moment breath is gone, you are gone. Not the physical body. You are not the physical body. Am I able to convince you that? Because if you are the physical body, if the breath is gone, people should again keep you in the house. They won't keep you in the house if the breath is gone. Even though they feel bad, the agony and maybe anguish, and in between us, somebody may feel happy also. But this proves that you are the breath. That is the basics of Gayatri Mantra, where it's saying, Soham, I am the breath, I am that. So, that, hum, I am. That I am, that I am. This is the first practice. And this you have to do whenever you remember it. Don't worry about sitting in some place or going to a particular place and do it. Be aware of your breath. The next one, relaxation response. For this relaxation response, the cardiologists say that the moment when you are aware of your breath, the relaxation happens. Automatically it happens. You don't try to relax, because the moment you try, again the stress and strain come. Don't try it. Just be aware of the breath. The relaxation response comes. And when you relax, that is the real state of sleep. Don't you know that sleep is the best relaxed condition? And if you can enter that state while breathing, physically, you can be sure of many of your illnesses will be gone. You can change your fate, and you can bring your dreams to happen physically. And there is a methodology of what we call to bring your dreams to physical plane as meditation. Many people just simply close their eyes and sit quietly. Of course, it relaxes. But the real purpose of meditation is to bring down the dreams into the physical plane. So breathing, which puts you into the relaxation response, and in that relaxed state, if you can dream properly, whatever you think happens. So this is the great truth. And do you think there is any religion in it? Am I talking about any religion? Practice it then. But that name helps, just as NO helps to understand nitrous oxide, that name helps. Okay? So Jai Gurudev. I have finished. But remember, you see the websites, at least Akhila Vishwa Gayatri Parivar website, Deva Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya website. And of course, if you are interested in this relaxation response and this. And sometimes I am asking my friends that monthly once, if you can interact with your questions and your practices, we can go together. We'll plan. Yes? Any questions? Yes?
I had two questions.
Yes?
Connected to each other. When we are talking about conservation of energy, we consider Atma as energy.
Yes.
Subsequent question. If the energy is not created nor destroyed, where is the population? Why the population is increased?
You accept science as it says that the number of atoms can't be increased. The number of carbon atoms, the number of calcium atoms. But why so many plastics and organic molecules are coming suddenly? And I have read that in organic chemistry in 1 hour, 10,000 new molecules are being added. So the population is increasing. But the basics have not changed. Got the point? Your utilization is being shifting. Energy is converted more into more the organic molecules. But the total energy and the total mass is same.
You mean it's a transformation of a energy?
The soul is being transformed as a material human being. Or in our Hindu language, we can call it as the reincarnation of souls has increased. Previously, suppose there were 100 souls, 30 souls on the physical plane and 70 souls there. Now it has reversed. 30 there and 70 now, and you find a population increase. Got it? The reincarnation, because of the specific purpose. When we are talking about this reincarnation, there's a beautiful book about reincarnation and karma by Edgar Cayce. The book was, of course, written by Gina Serminara. The name of the book is Many Mansions, and I have a series of lectures on it, the karma theory. You just
the
write it.
Karma.
You have in our website also a series of lectures. Okay? Any more questions? Yes?
How would we awaken ourselves in the sleep state?
When you can forget about the time. Actually, the sleep state is a no time barrier. That much you understood. So if in meditative state, if you can jump into that no time conscious state, but you are conscious of yourself. Time flows outside. You are only a part witness of it. That is what we call the sadhana of Sakshi Bhava, watcher consciousness. So if you can go into the watcher consciousness, that I am only watching, nothing is happening, then you go into that sleep state. It's a simple practice, just like balancing cycle. I say it is very easy, but one who doesn't know cycling, it is very difficult. So it's just a question of practice. You can jump into it. So many yogis, so many saints, so many prophets. Prophets means who talk about the future and this. They are in that state and they predict. And it is not a difficult state. It is only to be achieved. You have to wish for it. And a real wish. A real wish is always joined with effort. A real effort. Okay? What is the question? When you are sleeping?
What is your soul doing?
A very difficult question to answer. Because a soul can ask a body to do, but a body cannot ask the soul. Because this is a lower level and this is a higher level. So you can't ask it. The question is good. Because what the soul, if you can say, do you know what it means? It means you are the soul, then the powers must be there. So I don't advise people to go for the intellectual discussion. Be the soul. Got the point? What the soul thinks when you are asleep, if you can say. Are you in that soul level state or in the conscious state, physical conscious? How can you answer that?
I cannot.
That is why they say avang manasa gochara. By words or mind you can't understand it. There is a limit.
In the morning I had a very good sleep in the night.
That's okay.
That
soul gives you. But it is giving you in your wakeful consciousness. But as a soul, it knows, but you don't know. You have to identify with soul. We are identifying. What is the question when you are sleeping?
What is your soul doing?
Ha! A very difficult question to answer. Because a soul can ask a body to do, but a body cannot ask the soul, because this is a lower level and this is a higher level. So you can't ask it. The question is good. Because what the soul, if you can say, do you know what it means? It means you are the soul, then the powers must be there. So I don't advise people to go for the intellectual discussion. Be the soul. Got the point? What the soul thinks when you are asleep, if you can say. Are you in that soul level state or in the conscious state, physical conscious? How can you answer that?
I have a
You cannot. That is why they say avang manasa gochara. By words or mind you can't understand it. There is a limit.
In the morning I had a very good sleep in the night.
That's okay.
That
soul gives you. But it is giving you in your wakeful consciousness. But as a soul it knows, but you don't know. You have to identify with soul. We are identifying with this body. Yes.
Coming back to the point that you gave to breath and
relaxation
response. How do you relate Gayatri Mantra with the breath?
The Gayatri Mantra says that there are three levels of consciousness. So each eight-lettered letters, Tatsavitur Varenyam, deals with the physical consciousness. Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi deals with the dream consciousness. Dhiyo Yonaha Prachodaya deals with the soul consciousness. That's how it is related. And what we are trying to do, we want all the three to become one. They have to be unified. That is why we ask people to chant it together, so that you will be beyond the time. You are alive because of the breath.
So when you concentrate always that you are breathing.
No, just a minute. I will talk. Give an example in zoology. The longevity of your life depends on the number of breaths you take per minute. They have proved it. Those who breathe at a faster rate, the animals, 30, 35, they live only for 12 years. And there are some animals like the elephant and the tortoise. They say they breathe only for 4 minutes. Sorry, 4 breaths per minute. They live for 500 years. And we, if we regularly correctly breathe 16 to 17 breaths per minute, we have to live exactly for 100 years. But why the longevity has decreased? Because we run for the bus. The breath rating, we become angry, the breath rate increases. Got the point? So that is how your life depends on breath and breath rate.
Okay. So how is reciting Gayatri Mantra would help?
How? You know that certain sounds increase your breath. You accept that point?
Yes.
And there are certain sounds which decreases our breath. And this is Gayatri Mantra, it neither decreases nor increases, it unifies the breath in the three levels of consciousness because of the sound. That is why Param Pujya Gurudev always used to say, don't worry about the meaning of the mantra. Just go on chanting it, the three levels become united. Now you got your answer? And that is why I always advise you, when you are doing it, don't think about the mantra's meaning. You go to the vibrations.
It's not related to Sanskrit or anything.
Yes.
It's basically a sound.
Sound and already existing in your body.
Right. So, that does that mean that you have to chant Gayatri Mantra in a certain way, in certain sound?
No, no. It takes its own rhythm. You don't worry, because we are talking about some very great power. You don't try to control it, but you be very clear that you are chanting properly. That means every letter is being chanted. Every letter must be uttered. No, you do it. I am just saying it because I have to tell you how you have to do. What the exact process is, the lips must move. The tongue must move, the sound should not be audible. You get the vibrations properly.
But I have heard that since maybe some people, somewhere I have heard that the Gayatri Mantra should be chanted in a certain way.
You know, now a certain medicine should be used like this, a MBBS says. A MD says, no, you should use like this. And the MD-DM says, no, they are wrong, you should do like this. Whose words you will accept? MBBS, MD or MD-DM? MD-DM is it not? A man who has done such a great sadhana and his background is Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, who realized all the gods and goddesses. He says you do like that. And why do you worry about somebody who says like that? Okay? Yes? Yes?
How do you achieve dream consciousness? You said you get to have a consciousness of a dream before you can make it a reality. But the fact is most people don't remember what they dream.
Yes.
Generally. So how would they ever have that consciousness as to what they were dreaming, and then how would they convert that to
So you are asking me how the breathing process empowers you the dream power. Am I right?
Right.
Okay. There are two types of dreams. One type of dreaming is known as the daydreaming. Many people do that while going in the bus or when they are relaxing. A daydreaming means they are not worried about what they are dreaming. They are just enjoying it. It's okay. And now there are certain dreams which we wanted to materialize. So, instead of daydreaming, if you can think of what you want to materialize, for example, about health, if you want to utilize the power of dreaming, you don't worry about your disease. You don't dream that when you utter and you think also it is a dream, even if you don't really visualize. No, I am becoming very sick, I don't know what happens, and after that some troubles will come and this weakness will come. This is a negative way of dreaming. This empowers the negative process. But suppose you visualize that I am very healthy. And you behave as if you are healthy. Many people tell me, you say that by just thinking that I know it happens. Are you also asking the same question? All of you? Now, how thinking as if gives you that power is how you learn driving a car. How do you learn driving a car? Sitting beside the driver or sitting in the driver's seat? You sit in the driver's seat. Do you know driving? And why are you all sitting in the driver's seat? Because you behave as if you know. But in the beginning, you will do it only in a restricted area, in a safe area. When you understand the dream steps, as if steps are nothing but dream steps, then what happens? You become a driver. And if you are sincere, you can become a race driver also. So the as if thinking is dreaming. And but you have to behave as if. If you want to be healthy, and you have to behave as if you are healthy. But don't behave it outside, because if they see behaving like that, you say you work. So in the room you behave as if you are healthy. Am I clear now how to empower the dreams? They're together. They're together. A thought becomes a visualization. A word becomes a visualization. It becomes a dream. Almost thinking and visualization are one and the same thing, because each word has a vision. When I say a pen, we say a dog, we saw a cow. So each word has a figure.
You can materialize that. Meditation.
Very easily, very, very easily. But it, and don't think it is a very great practice. Learning car driving, when you don't know how difficult it is. But I think generally the principles you can learn in 4 hours. Is it not? So why not utilizing the day dreaming in 4 hours? You can, but the seriousness must be there. Seriousness is behaving as if you have become. That's that point. And our all education system is making you to behave like that. An engineering course makes you behave like an engineer. A medical course makes you behave like a doctor. Is it not? So it is the same process. But because all are doing it, you say it is not dream coming true, it is your effort coming true. But actually you have dreamt to become an engineer. You tried for 5 years. I don't know here the time period for engineering. In South India it is 5 years. So in 5 years of behaving as if an engineer, you became an engineer. For five years you practice to become a surgeon. You become a doctor. So that is how your words, your thoughts become facts. So why not other things also? If your thoughts make you a doctor, if your thoughts can make an engineer, why can't your other thoughts also happen? The only thing is we don't behave as if we have got it. Am I clear now?
Yeah, I think over here they call that the law of attraction. I think the American books on that subject.
They have some wonderful books.
And they've taken what you're saying.
Yes.
Very, very simple.
Correct.
I think you're
watching. I am forgetting her name. She has written some beautiful books on dreaming. I'm forgetting the author. It's okay. The principles are same. Whatever may be the name, the facts are this. And it is very easy to practice. Never think it is difficult. It is natural for you. That is how we have dreamt our body. Our human body is our dream. We forget about that. Yes? What's the name?
And Masterji, you must be knowing which one Vangma it's from.
It is mainly from the Gayatri Mahavigyan third volume.
Okay, Gayatri Mahavigyan third volume.
You get all these details.
Also right here, Gayatri Mahavigyan in all languages, it's here.
The science of Gayatri. Maha means great. There he gives a number of experiments and meditations on the physical body, on the emotional body, on the mental body, and on the intuitional body, and of course on the happy body or the bliss body, in that book, third volume. Yes?
Practical question. Once we start concentrating on our breathing, what is the next achievement? Because after a couple of minutes, either we forget what we are doing.
In the beginning. Later it leads you. Later it leads you, it takes you in.
So we should know where we are leading.
You don't worry, don't worry. It takes you. Because you know only on the physical plane consciousness. So whatever you guide and do, it will be limited to the physical plane. Let it enter, let it enter. That is what the inner awakening I am talking about. Many people give you advice about what you do in the physical aspect. But when you do only on the physical aspect, where is your consciousness? It is in the physical aspects. How can you go in? But it is the breath which goes in, because even in sleep, no thoughts are there, the breathing is there. Is it not? So if you concentrate on breathing and try to allow it where it goes, it leads you to deeper and deeper even into the sleep state. So never try to guide it. Because you try it, it doesn't matter. But what happens is you are limiting it. Am I able to convey what I want to tell you? Just let it happen. Be aware of it. That's all. Don't do anything. And that gives you the relaxation. And that relaxation responds that this is free of diabetes, BPs and cancers. And you just type that relaxation response and you have so many cardiologists who are now supporting it. Real cardiologists, I mean. When I say real cardiologists, I mean really who are practicing it day-to-day life on so many patients. They are confirming it, that breathing this and relax, you are cured. Yes, somebody else? Huh? You want a meditation technique where you will be safe from negative vibrations.
Yeah.
Is that the question?
Yeah. How do you channel your negative thoughts?
There are two methods actually. One is of course this breathing technique. If you are aware of the breath, it's okay. There is one method. The other method is what is known as affirmations. Affirmations means you take a decision. From now onwards, I will always think positively. You write maximum three, these affirmations you limit only to those three words. Is it not? But Gayatri Mantra leads you to all the planes of consciousness. Positively.
Can you please explain the link between Gayatri Mantra, pranic energy and thought power?
Yes. Just now I told you that there are five levels of consciousness in Gayatri Mahavigyan. The physical plane, the emotional plane or pranic plane. The emotional and vital plane is one and the same thing. The vitality depends on the emotion. And then the thought, manomai kosha, the mental plane. And beyond that Gayatri Mantra takes the intuitional plane and the bliss plane. Now you understood the link? Thoughts are manomaya, mental plane. Emotions are the pranamaya, pranic healing. And of course, the physical. You got your answer?
So, what do we call as a samadhi state? You said
a continuity of this, a co-linking, a coordinated reaction to all these three planes, and one is controlling the other. The physical plane controlling the sleep state is controlling the physical plane, and both these two are emotionally controlled by the dream, and all three are working together in unison. That is sama, dhi. Sama means equal, dhi means intuition. So it is not just sitting with a closed eyes. You should be very well aware of the speed of the 24 hours, the fast speed in the dream level, and no speed level beyond time. You should be aware of these three. That is samadhi. And because it is a state of no time, even when you go to the samadhis of the people like Sai Samadhi, because it is beyond time, you get the same result as if Sai is there. That is why, because he is in samadhi. We call it samadhi, but you think that we are talking about the physical tomb. No. And literally all tombs, and when I am using this word, I mean all tombs. They are in the samadhi state, they are not aware of it. Sai and Jesus Christ are aware of it. The awareness is important. Suppose I am thinking something and I am walking, and a very close friend of mine comes before me. Don't you think I may miss him because I am not aware that he is coming because I am thinking elsewhere? So that mistake is happening. But with Sai and Christ and Muhammad and the Sikh gurus, the Sadgurus, they are all in that plane which is beyond time, and therefore there is no death, and that is why they are immortal. Because death is a time concept. When there is no death, how can you die? You cannot die. But you have to go there. And there are many yogis and many prophets who have been there, and still you can meet them. There are so many people who meet Sai, who has seen Christ, who has seen Muhammad, who has seen their gurus physically. And you think it is their imagination, but you know it is not an imagination. But because you can't have it, you can call it imagination. For you it is an imagination. But it is an image, a murti, a crystallized form. Okay? Samadhi, yes?
Is it wise to draw a line to say alankaric representations and practically really what happened in the past with all other gods and avatars?
No, no. They are realities.
Up to avatars?
With us also. We are also divine. We are not aware of it. And the yogis say that you do this, you will realize. So the limitation is our knowledge, our understanding, our acceptance. The avatars, the incarnations prove that just by thinking you can change it. For this you need a little practice, as I was telling. If you are not a car driving and somebody gives you, if you don't know the car driving and someone gives you the keys, what do you say? Will you drive or you say, I don't know? You won't drive. But to learn it, how many years you need? How many years? 4 hours is enough. The same thing here also. If you can understand the guru, the teacher, you can instantaneously realize. That is why Patanjali in his Yoga Sutras say, Tivra Samvega Nama Asannaha, if your depth is very strong, now itself you can get. And what Parampuja Gurudev used to say, you say, nowhere I find people. You just change the comma. Nowhere becomes now, here. The same letters. It all depends on how you see it. I don't find nowhere. I find now here. Are the same words or different words? Same words. How much time it took, say, I am seeing it nowhere and I am seeing it now here. How much time do you want? Inspiration. That is where we should work together, because in the beginning, when the doctors used to tell us you should walk, and in the morning I wanted to walk and I couldn't get up at that time. But when 5 of us joined together, if I can't get up, he comes and makes me get up. And when he does not get up, I go and awaken him and we walk together. So the union, especially this type of scientific thinking from such a great man, where there is no restrictions of anything except your interest. Let us join together. Instantaneously it happens. Okay? Okay? Jai Gurudev.
Can you excuse me for
that
few minutes? We have some time.
Okay. I thought if no questions, it's okay.
No,
many questions? Only 2 questions.
Okay.
2 more questions.
Okay. Why don't you talk a little bit about the mission, the importance, and the literature and the Kranti Devi?
And now, I studied in Varanasi, Kashi. Kashi is a religious place where so many yogis are there. And the legend says that always in Kashi, at least always there will be 500 Buddha level people, always with physical body. So that is the legend. And those who know, it is not a legend, it is a fact. Because we find it is very difficult that if there are 500 Buddha, you know, Lord Buddha, and if Kashi is such a place, why we are not able to see? You don't want to see. If you want to see, you can see them. The Sarnath is very nearby, where the Buddha's first message has been given. Why I am telling this is, I have 39 teachers, yogic teachers, including Ananda Mahima, Indira Gandhi's, and Rajneesh. Though he doesn't belong to Kashi, and Ananda Mahima belongs to Bengal, they used to come to Kashi and give lectures, and I used to attend. I was a very close disciple to such 39 gurus. But accidentally, physically, but really, it was managed by him that a book relating about him fall when I was on a bus from somebody's, the Akhanda Jyoti magazine. And when I went there, that was in 1971. Till 1971, I had until then 39 gurus, and my parents always used to criticize, by the end of your life you will hit a century, you will have 100 gurus. Because that was my 19th year or so, and I had 39 very famous gurus. Devariya Baba, you heard about Devariya Baba? I had been his disciple. Ananda Mahima, Rajneesh, and there are some Gita and other people whom probably you may not be knowing, Shobha Maharani in Kashi. But when I went to him, suddenly I found that I have reached my goal. After that I had no other gurus, I didn't need any guru. But one problem is there. That is, in my 20th year I met him, and now I am entering the 60th year, so 40 years. And I feel very, very sorry that I couldn't complete his books. I have not completely understood him. Every year I find a new aspect of him. And one of the most brilliant and what is very useful for us, that he has written thousands of books on translation, Sanskrit to Hindi, Sanskrit to Hindi, all written by Vedavyasa and others. 108 Upanishads, 24 Smritis, 24 Gayatris, the Patanjali Yoga Sutras, all he has translated. And himself he has written 3,200 books. Individually, personally, has written 3,200 books. And along with this activity, he used to bring out a magazine of 64 pages without any advertisement and no figures. Everything is a written material written by him every month for 40 years. You are trying to understand the stupendous attempt of writing he has done. And now in 1984, he gave me a blessing. People like me who feel that they are not able to finish his literature. He said, I am giving you 20 pamphlets. He says 20 books. But they are so small size books, I would try to say it a pamphlet. As the simple, we read English novels of this size. And together this size, the 20 books will come only to this size. So this is what he writes as the science of revolution, the science of changing yourself, S-C-I-E-N-C, the technology of seeing, changing yourself. In these 20 books, he writes that these 20 books on one side, and whatever I have written on the other side, these 20 books will weigh more. That is a blessing. I need not read all those books. If I read these 20 books, and he is the authority who says that if you read these 20 books, this is heavier than what I have read. Do you mean the formula is always heavier than the textbook, is it not? Mass energy equivalence, if they write a book, it needs at least 300 to 400 people to convey. But if you say is equal to mc squared, 3 words are enough. So similarly, these 20 books are the entire basis of these three types of changes in consciousness, the physical, the emotional, the dream state, and the thought process. These are the some English versions are now coming, the Hindi versions are 20, the Telugu versions are also 20, the Kannada and Tamil are also coming in 20. So I advise you go through this. If you want, whatever I wanted to tell, this is the Telugu set, 20 books. And English very soon you are going to get. Very soon means 2 months. Or less than 60 days. Okay? And some of them are already there. Okay, Datta? Okay, I have conveyed it? Okay. Now, sometimes I miss, because I was more concentrating on the awakening, inner awakening, I forgot this point, and I am happy she told, because such a great man in his various aspects, it is very difficult to convey in one lecture. But if I can convey to create an interest in you, if I could, I will be happy to know about it. Okay? My experience?
Yeah, at least one.
Have a lot. Yeah, I have a lot and lot, because I was a science student, and in the 18th year and 19th year, the science students are always revolt. They don't believe in spiritualism and this and that. And all these 39 gurus, I was a headache to them. I asked to this and that, and he became a headache to me. Now I have to read and read and read. I have nothing, no time to question. So that is one experience. But the most important experience what I have with him is a guarantee he gave that whenever you need me, I am always with you. Always. And that is applicable to you also, to all the humanity. Thousands and thousands of experiences about financial problems, about life problems, life and death problems, and intellectual problems where they are not able to. For example, I don't give you the name because I don't think that scientists will like it to be known. In Banaras Hindu University, while I was doing research, one scientist there in the university professors has a problem about the scientific problem. It is about the statistical aspects. How statistics is to guide people, that is his problem. I don't know exactly what the problem is. But because I was a research scholar and he is a professor, we used to have some interaction like this in some meetings. And I was sitting beside him, and someone from Delhi was giving his lecture. The problem came about his problem. I said, my Guruji always used to say that I am there to help anybody in any field. And so I told, my Guruji is like that. He said, are you sure? No, I am not sure, I am certain. Do you believe it? No, I don't believe it. I accept it and I know it that it is truth. It is not a belief. I have seen so many incidences that I know it will happen. So he said, then I am giving you an impossible target to your guru. Tomorrow morning when I come to the college, the solution must be on my table. He has to solve it and he is not going there. And he says, okay, you are saying like that. Next day, a professor running to a research scholar in another department, gasping and with tears in his eyes, he said, yes, it is there on my table. It was there. So this type of experiences, all of you can get it. The only thing is, be sincere. I am not saying you accept it. Don't say, but be aware that if that happens, you will not miss. Because when you don't believe, you will not be aware. So I am only talking about being aware. You will see all the miracles. There are so many in my life. If I want to narrate it, it will become a huge book. A series of such examples. Yesterday I told you about somebody coming out of his death. And myself about my research work and other things in my life. Many, many times I find his supporting hand. And my friends, their parents were my friends. They are my parents' children. their parents know the miracles. And they are not miracles, it is only speeding up the time. If suppose you are to have to suffer with a particular disease for 20 years, his presence finishes those 20 years in 1 second, because in the dream state if you can take you. And how he takes, of course I know the little science of it, I have given the examples, but you have to do it. And these 20 books, again this I am giving from my experience, if you study these 20 books, all his knowledge comes to you. And why 20 books only? Some other time.
Shanti, Antariksha Gum Shanti, Prithvi Shanti, Aapas Shanti, Oshadhaya Shanti, Vanaspatayas Shanti, Visvedeva Shanti, Brahma Shanti, Sarvagum Shanti, Shanti Reva Shanti, Sama Shanti Reti. Om Shanti Sarvaristan Susantir Bhavatu Sarvejana Sukhino Bhavantu. Jai Gopal.